Well, good morning, church family. It is Wednesday, May the 6th, and I hope that you are day by day during this season, during this time, growing closer to God, getting into the truth of His Word, and just leaning and resting in the truth of who God is and the love that He has for you. And so what I want to do today is, today's devotion comes out of 1 John chapter 4, verses 16 through 21. That's 1 John chapter 4, 16 through 21. And I want to read it. And again, I just want to say that I'm excited about seeing some of you, those that can make it on Sunday, May the 17th. For worship here, and it's going to be a good Sunday, and hopefully that's about a week and a half actually from today, so it'll be a good Sunday on Sunday, May the 17th. But today's devotion comes out of 1 John chapter 4, verses 16 through 21. I'm going to read it, and then we're going to briefly talk about it. And it says this, it says, "And so we know and rely on the love that God has for us. God is love. Whoever lives in love lives in God, and God in them. This is how love is made complete among us, so that we will have confidence on the day of judgment. In this world, we are like Jesus. There is no fear in love. But perfect love drives out fear, because fear has to do with punishment. The one who fears is not made perfect in love. We love because He first loved us. Whoever claims to love God yet hates a brother or sister is a liar. For whoever does not love their brother and sister whom they have seen cannot love God whom they have not seen. And He has given us this command: anyone who loves God must also love their brother and sister." There's a lot of statements about the word love, but I want to really land on one verse that says, "There is no fear in love, but perfect love drives out fear." And so today I want us to think about two things. I want us to, first and foremost, we are supposed to love God, and sometimes that is hard to do, depending on the season, what's going on in our life. I mean, just to be honest with you, sometimes that's hard to do. But just like down here on earth, sometimes it's hard to love the people that we're supposed to love, just to be honest with you. But in everything that we do, you and I are supposed to love God. And I think actually that's the easier of the two things, because the second thing that we're supposed to do, and I think this is where really we need to understand this verse, is the second thing is we are supposed to really understand that God loves us. And that becomes very difficult whenever we go through hard circumstances, whenever we're brokenhearted, or whenever we're hurt, whenever we're angry, things in life aren't going the way we think they're supposed to go, or the way they're that different from our plans. And we think that God doesn't love us. But what I want us to do today is this, is sure, I want you to think about how God loves you. I want us to think about how we love God and how we show God our love. But what I want us to do today, and I want you to do today, is sit and think about how much God loves you. No matter what's going on in your life, no matter what hurt you may feel, God truly, truly loves you. And He understands the pain that you're going through. He understands the situations that you're going through. And I think whenever we just pause and really just break the walls of our heart down and realize that God loves us, that someone loves us unconditionally, that He loves us unconditionally, that's whenever that fear drives out. That fear that it speaks over here, perfect love drives out fear. That's whenever I really believe that we start understanding that we should not be afraid, because we have a God that loves us. The God that created the universe loves you, and he loves me. And so my prayer today is that you just think about those two things, how much you love God, but then rest and find peace in the fact that God loves you no matter what you're going through. It may not feel that way right now during some of the circumstances in life that's going on, but God loves you. And my prayer is that you find peace in that today, because he loves you. So let's pray. Father God, I thank you for your son Jesus and the grace and mercy that comes through him. God, one of the hardest things for us to do, I think, is to believe that somebody can love us. Because sometimes we feel so unlovable. And my prayer is that as this day goes on, God, that we're able to pause and let you, and that, not let you, because we don't let you do anything, but God, that we pause and realize that you are constantly loving us, that you are constantly showering your grace upon us. Even though it may be hard circumstances in life, maybe the things we don't understand, but the truth is, God, that you do love us. And I thank you for that. I thank you for sending your son Jesus to die on the cross for my sin and our sins, Lord. God, I thank you for raising him again on the third day. So he defeated sin and he defeated death. And God, my prayer is that today that you would just continue to pour the love upon us. But Lord, break the walls of our heart that maybe we've built up, maybe against you or whatever, God. Break those today. God, we love you. I honor you. In Jesus' name, amen. Church family, I love you. I'm praying for you. I can't wait to see you. Please, please, please understand that God loves you. And just think about those two things today, how much you love God and how much God loves you. Because in love, perfect love drives out fear. And that's my prayer for you today, that you would feel no fear. I love you. Get into God's truth. It is his truth. And as always, there is always hope in Christ Jesus. I love you. God bless. See you tomorrow.